your seats and we will begin the program. Okay. On behalf of Atsugi and the Heritage Committee, we would like to thank all of you for coming to this month's Heritage Program honoring the Native American culture and their influence in our lives. I am Mayor Cornier and I will be your Master of Ceremonies. Will everyone please rise for the singing of the national anthems? And please welcome to the front PSSA Smith and JMSDF Petty Officer 2nd Class Takahashi for the singing.
Oh, theories and principles that the Iroquois Nation developed. So this club, the Iroquois Club, has 60 members and over 10,000 acres of beautiful, lush, wooded lands. And the namesake, Iroquois, were also made up of five nations. And these five nations all came together in order to build off one another, in order to rely on one another, to live off the land, to come together in a democracy in order to live their lifestyle. And so this club that we belong to is very similar, and the structure of it is modeled after the Iroquois nation. And so no one owns land, similar to Iroquois tradition there. Everyone takes part in the club. We all give our dues, whether it's in work parties, you know, building a barn or shoveling snow for an elderly neighbor. And that's some of the traditions that we got from our ancestors in the Iroquois nation. So that's something that we learned to appreciate growing up, is living in this society in which you're not alone. You're a community, and everyone gives their part in order to make the community better. So also in this club, I was brought up appreciating what nature could offer me. So throughout all seasons, in the summertime, whether it's canoeing in the lakes or fly fishing in the rivers, or in the winter, ice fishing in the fall, hunting for deer, we used everything that the land could offer us, animals included. You know, we don't hunt for game. Animals were provided to us in order to eat them. So I was brought up in a tradition where you hunt a deer, you eat the entire deer. So it's traditions like these that I've learned to appreciate. Let's see. So for me, this living in nature was really the best lifestyle I could ask for. So any of you girls, do you often go on like a nature hike, or sometimes climb up a mountain, or go swimming in a lake? Yeah? Do you guys like being out in nature and appreciating everything that it has to offer? Yeah, me too. So that's the way I grew up. I grew up loving to live off the land. There were no iPads or iPods or any Apple products. So that's one of the best things that the Native Americans taught me, is how to enjoy life without any electronics. So I have my dad to thank for that, and I have the Iroquois Nation that developed our club, the Iroquois Club. So that's about all I have today. I urge you girls to maybe go out there and enjoy nature the way that I've learned to enjoy it, without a phone, without an iPad. You can really have a lot of fun. Thank you.
I would now like to take this opportunity to welcome MA2 Air to the Napa Security Department on stage.
Good afternoon, everybody. I'll be reading a poem called Great Spirit Prayer by Big Thunder. Give us hearts to understand, never to take from creation's beauty more than we give, never to destroy, want only for the furtherance of greed. Never to deny, to give our hands for the building of the earth's beauty. Never to take from her what we cannot use. Give us hearts to understand that to destroy earth's music is to create confusion, that to wreck her appearance is to blind us to beauty, and that as we care for her, she will care for us. We have forgotten who we are. We have sought only our own security. We have exploited simply for our own needs. We have distorted our knowledge, and we have abused our power. Great Spirit, whose dry land thirst, help us to find a way to refresh your lands. Great Spirit, whose waters are choked with debris and pollution, help us to find the way to cleanse your waters. Great Spirit, whose beautiful earth grows ugly with misuse, help us to find a way to restore beauty into your handiwork. Great Spirit, whose creatures are being destroyed, help us find a way to replenish them. Great Spirit, whose gifts to us are being lost in selfishness and corruption, help us find a way to restore our humanity. O Great Spirit, whose voice I hear in the wind, whose breath gives life to the world. Hear me. I need your strength and wisdom. May I walk in you.
I would like now like to welcome BU1. BU1, Ramirez Cardenas of NAFAC.
Jacqueline, thank you for the class. I'm going to talk about the history of how we got the month and how they fought through years and since 1990. We have the month now too on them. American Indian culture are known for their rich and oral tradition. They used to share the history, custom, tributes, and legends through the vivid narrative. Each time a story was told, it breathed life into their culture, cultivated their formal language, gave meaning to the tribe history, and also taught life lessons about leadership and honor. In 1914, Red Fox James, a Blackfoot Indian, rode a horseback from state to state seeking support for a day to honor American Indians. A year later, James represented the endorsement of 24 states governed by the White House. There's no record of Nation Day being proclaimed in respect despite his efforts. In 1915, the Congressman of American Indian Association approved a formal plan to celebrate American Indian Day. Reverend Sherman Coolidge, an Arapaho tribe member, asked the country to formally set aside a date to recognition. In 1924, Congress enacted the Indian Citizenship Act, but it took no action to establish a nation, American Indian Day. It wasn't until 1986 that Congress passed a proclamation authorizing American Indian Week. In 1990, a month of November was designated as Nation American Indian Heritage Month. The title was since extracted to celebrate Alaskan Native. National American Indian and Alaskan Native Heritage Month is celebrated to recognize Native cultures and educate the public about heritage, history, art, and traditions of American Indian and Alaskan Native. Did you know that American Indians have the highest population per capita in ethnic groups serving the military? American Indians has participated in the United States military action for more than 200 years. Their culture determined the fighting spirit we recognize by American military leaders as early 18th century. Today, 22,248 American Indians served in the armed forces, making 1.7% of the military population. Additionally, according to the DOD, there is worth 157,550 American Indian veterans as of March 2012. Currently, there are 566 federal recognized American Indians and Alaskan Native tribes, and more than 100 states recognize the tribe according to the United States. Native Alaskan tribes belong to 5 geographic areas, are recognized under 13 Alaskan tribes, regions, incorporated speaking 11 different languages and 22 different dialects, as they all do, as all have 11 district cultures. Federally recognized tribe recognized certain inheritance rights as self-governed tribal associations, as they are entitled to recognize certain federal benefits, service, and protection because of their relationship with the United States. Sovereignty is a right to a nation or a group or person to be self-governed, and is most fundamental. fundamental concept that defines the relation between the government of the United States and the government of American Indian tribe. American Indians and Alaskan Natives are U.S. citizens and citizens of the tribe. They are citizens of federal law, but they are not always subject to state law. As the first people to live in the land we all cherish, American Indians and Alaskan Natives have probably shaped our country, characters, and culture's heritage. Today, American Indians are leaders in every aspect of society, from the classroom to the boardroom to the battlefield. Thank you.
Thank you very much, B1. Now, this is a special time right now. The next individual that's going to be coming up to speak is Native American himself, one of the few that we were able to locate here on our installation. He has some great insights, some great information that he'll be talking about when he comes up here. And if you would all welcome TC Shoots up to the stage.
That's good morning, Cherokee. I'm one in Cherokee. My grandfather was half. My great grandmother was full blooded Cherokee. Found her way to Southern Illinois due to the Trail of Tears. I never got a chance to meet her, but my grandfather carried on the tradition of the Cherokee. We only take what's needed, never more than what's needed from the earth. His great spirit, and his service to great spirit. As JG was saying, we never kill more than what we need. We grow, we harvest, we take from nature, and we do that. Never leave a trace that we were there. The greatest thing to be Native American, the greatest thing that you can ever aspire to be, is a human being. What that means, yes, we're all humans, but to be a human being, you respect each other, love each other. No one controls anybody. You're a family unit. The biggest thing believed by the Native American is that we are all a family. And that's why you normally won't see a Native American taking up politics. They don't believe in controlling another man. On the other hand, my wife, she is Choctaw and Cherokee. She's a direct descendant of Pata Shehati. She was a direct liaison between the Choctaw Nation and the United States government. There's a rich culture is rich heritage they can take from the Native Americans. Most won't come forward and say they're Native American. They're very quiet, humble. But one thing you always remember, if you listen to them, is only take what you need and treat everybody with respect.
Next, we do have a special treat from the children of Shirley Lanham Elementary School. We'd like to welcome you to the stage to present your song and dance. Thank you. next guest I'd like to bring up, I'd like to introduce to you the Naval Air Facility Security Officer, Lieutenant Watson. We've got our closing remarks. Lieutenant Watson.
Let's give the children another hand. That was these guys did a fantastic job today, and I'm very, very proud of each and every one of you guys. I also would like to thank everyone who participated in the program, the Heritage Committee, who works tirelessly behind the scenes. You guys, you're phenomenal, and I appreciate everything you guys do to recognize each and every event that we have here. The guest speaker, phenomenal. That was a good job. It may seem like it's easy for everybody to get up here and talk in front of folks, but it's not. It's not that easy to get up here and talk in front of a large group of people about issues and different concerns that we have in the world today, but the Native American history is one of very much of a controversy. And although we have come a long way, but the treatment and the respect of our Native Americans, we have a lot more than we can do for them. Much, much more than we can do. There's a lot more that could be done and should be done to make things better for everyone. For as we know and we were taught, Christopher Columbus discovered America. Well, they were already here. He took the credit, but Native Americans were already here living their lives, embracing the land, and preserving the culture. It is my sincere hope that through programs such as these, that we may inspire a movement of change, a movement of equality for all nationalities. For if we just sit here and do nothing, then nothing will ever change. It starts with each and every one of you. Each and every one of you can make a difference. And if you don't know the full story, or even part of the story, then I challenge each of you to do a little research and find out the true history. For it is only when we study and truly understand the past that then we can learn from it. And not only will we better ourselves, but we better a country, a nation, and ultimately, change the world. Thank you.
Well, this has to be one of the best closing remarks I've ever heard. But thank you all, yes, and thank you to everybody who participated. I'd like to thank, of course, the Heritage Committee, the base chapel for letting us use the chapel. I'd like to thank AESA for providing some refreshments for us. And I'd like to thank, of course, Shirley Lamb and everybody, distinguished guests. Thank you all for coming. This is now going to close our ceremony and our program for the day, but we would like to invite you back to this fellowship hall where there are some refreshments if you care to partake. And enjoy us back there. Thank you very much. Have a wonderful day.